where did all these constellations come from?
Welcome to Stargazers. I'm James Albury, director of the Kika Silva Pla Planetarium in Gainesville, Florida.
And I'm Dean Regas, astronomer from the Cincinnati Observatory. We're here to help you find your way around the sky tonight.
Hey, Dean, we have something special to talk about this week.
Oh, would that be another planetary close encounter or perhaps a super rare eclipse?
Well, none of those, actually. Well, a young viewer of our show visited my planetarium a while back, and his name is Henry. He asked me this question. Where did all these constellations come from? I thought that would be a great theme for this week's episode.
You're absolutely right. Well, Henry, we're going to answer your question right here on Stargazers. Where did all the sky pictures come from, and who came up with them?
Let's show you. For thousands of years, our ancestors have looked up at the night sky and wondered what it all was. Even as recently as 100 years ago, before the proliferation of streetlights, if you went outside on a clear moonless night, you could see thousands of stars right from your backyard.
Without a scientific explanation of what the stars were, many ancient cultures thought the stars were divine. Each star was considered a god, fixed in position relative to the others, appearing to rise in the east and set in the west night after night.
Imagine how magical, mysterious, and awesome the heavens must have seemed to our ancestors. As a person went from youth to old age, they would see the same stars in the same locations year after year, the same at age 5 as at age 50. And the sky seemed so high above them that the stars were unreachable, as if they were attached to the inside of a large crystalline sphere with us at the center.
And this crystalline sphere would appear to rotate around the Earth, again, with us at the center, making the stars appear to rise in the east and set in the west. This repetitive motion of the stars was very predictable, so many ancient people used the night sky as a primitive clock.
That's right, because not only was the daily motion of the stars repetitive, but over the course of a year, the stars you could see would gradually change. But 365 days later, the same stars you saw a year ago would appear in the same place. So if you look up at the stars after sunset on your birthday, you'll see the same stars in the same place every birthday for as long as you live.
The human brain likes to make order out of chaos. Although the distribution of the stars in the night sky is random, your brain immediately wants to make patterns out of the brightest stars.
So, as our ancestors spent their evenings gazing at the stars, they would play a game of celestial connect the dots, making patterns both big and small that represented objects, animals, or people. We call these patterns constellations.
There are currently 88 official constellations in modern astronomy. The constellations you can see depend on where on Earth you live. For example, people who live in Australia can see some of the same stars that we can see from North America, but not all of them, and vice versa.
Australians can see the Southern Cross, but only a few of us in North America can. North Americans can see Ursa Major, the Great Bear, but New Zealanders cannot. The only place on Earth where you can actually see all 88 constellations is at the equator.
So, as people around the world played connect the dots with the stars, they would create fanciful stories about each of the constellations they created. Many of these stories were used to pass down cultural values of morality or tell stories about love, courage, or honor.
These constellation stories were handed down from generation to generation. So, constellations came from stargazers like you.
So, great question, Henry. If you have a question or topic idea for the show, feel free to write to us at our website, stargazersonline.org.
In the meantime, you can always create your own constellations out of the stars you can see every night as you
keep looking up.
Looking up.